know that Kiwi rallying is at really good heart when you turn up here at Ohakune for the first round of the three-sport street skills series and you find 90 cars lining up for the start. Of course, they're not all state-of-the-art. There's the good, the bad, and the just plain. Actually, Will Orr's Impreza is one of very few Subarus among the front runners, a group dominated by Mitsubishi Lancers. Wellington ace Joe McAndrew heads the Subaru crew in his oldie but still a quickie Group A legacy, looking to continue his domination of this Powderhorn Chateau Rally.
Yeah, well, five times lucky, I reckon six times sounds pretty good.
And for the national title this year, what do you think?
Well, that's our main objective this year. Three-peat. Basically ourselves is the main competition of keeping the car in the middle of the road.
Seated second behind Plumber Joe is Reese the Builder. Jones, that is, in one of six Lancers.
Joe's car's still got far more power, better equipped. Now, I think we'll be trouble to try and beat Joe, but we'll probably be a bit closer than last year.
And that's what third seed Andrew Grant is hoping too.
Well, we're obviously hoping to take Group N, start with moderate pace today, see how the car feels. We've only just finished the development of the new restrictors. So we'll just see how it goes, open up slowly.
After a year off, Will Orr seems a little worried.
Yeah, I'm wondering whether it's the right thing to do, but no, we're happy.
The lone Nissan among the front runners is Jeff Argyle's Pulsar GTIR.
We'd like to be in the top three overall in the year, and you know, you never know. If things go well, we'll try the number one.
You weren't tempted to go buy one of those Lancers, were you?
No, I didn't have a big enough wallet.
A familiar face, back with a new Evo Mitsi Lancer, is Marty Rostenberg.
Been a while, mate.
It has, Wayne. Too long.
How long, actually?
6 years since we contested the national championship.
Manawatu driver Ross Thurston is out to defend his lead in the Street Skills North Island Challenge. Who wouldn't? It's worth $15,000.
It's most important because I haven't got any.
Same goes for the contenders for the 15 grand's worth of Street Skills scholarship. Kevin Holmes and Craig Marshall.
We're just driving through a schedule with two horse race, Kevin Holmes and myself. See how it goes.
Stumpy Holmes, meantime, is taking a cautious approach.
Well, we heard this rally is called the Safari Rally of New Zealand, so we're here to collect points, not to have a go, really.
But it's Marshall and Thurston who probably end up thinking more cautious would have been good. Dave Strong, too. Like Thurston, caught here, Strong and Marshall's brother Scott come to grief on a huge hole. The first three stages over super-fast gravel roads in Karioi Forest turn into a six-way contest. Joe Mack the champ versus Grant, Argyle Green, Jones and Jason Gardner. Grant shows what's possible with a new era Group N car by claiming first blood. McAndrew, meantime, is as frustrated as hell with the effect new turbo air restrictor rules have on his power.
Come on, you're going a bit.
But Grant overdoes his maximum attack on stage two, going off, losing half a minute and dropping to sixth place. And that makes it business as usual. McAndrew in the lead. Green loses time in a stage one Ford, but comes back with stage two honours to hold down second. Meanwhile, the Nissan man, and the other leading Mitzi pair, Jones and Gardner, stay consistent. Ore is spectacular, briefly, and then the Impreza motor blows. He's not alone with his problems. All morning in Karioi Forest, McAndrew is unable to win a stage, but stays in the lead thanks to Grant, Green and Jones sharing the honours. Green settles in second while Argyle and Jones scrap for third. But now comes Joe's woes, a puncture that coincides with the switch to tarmac, heavy rain and another Grant onslaught. Combination puts Green in the lead as Grant hauls back from 6th to 4th with two stage wins that pull back 29 seconds on the leader. Jones picks up 2nd and Rostenberg gets going and joins Jones and Argyle in the top 6. John Billington comes good in his Lancer, matching Jones' time for 4th on stage 4, only to crash over a bank after the finish. The same corner claims Hawke's Bay driver Ken Fraser and his Subaru Leone. Gardner also retires with serious overheating. As darkness falls, McAndrew's Shell team sees the light. They finally figure out how to get some power out of the Legacy despite its new restrictor. On the 6th stage, he finally wins one, hacking 27 seconds off Green to retake the lead.
Oh, I don't know, I just drove as hard as I bloody could, but I don't know if it's any good. It hasn't been much good in the last few stages.
When the Mazda's gearbox breaks, McAndrew puts the result beyond doubt with a convincing 1 minute 18 second win on a marathon 50k leg, one that catches out heaps of people. Jones takes a wrong turn and offs, but still holds second. Argyle and Rostenberg do the steady thing for third and fourth, and Grant takes a wrong turn to finish only 8th and slip back to 5th overall. And that's the rally. Fog and high winds cancelling the race to the Tūroa ski field. So a relieved McAndrew has 15 points for his championship campaign.
Yeah, a few balls out sessions there.
Jones has Group N sewn up for the moment, plus 2nd outright. Stumpy Holmes 7th puts him in the lead of the North Island Street Skills Scholarship and the Street Skills Challenge. David Black has wrung the neck of his little Corolla all day to come home in the top 10 behind Peter Day and Ross Martin, also claiming F2 honours.